In the last video, I showed you how to use the various ways of audio scrubbing in the sequence. In this lesson, I will explain the video track assignment using the patch panel. The patch panel, located to the left of the sequence, represents the source tracks and destination tracks. You will recognize their layout similar to other editors like Final Cut Pro 7 or Avid Media Composer. However, their operation is slightly different, and we'll get to that in a moment. Let's first examine what all the tabs mean. The dark gray tabs represent the tracks in the sequence. The description in each tab tells you what the track represents. In the case of the video tabs, they all have a version number and a layer number. You can have multiple versions of your edit in the sequence, but most people usually just stick to one to keep things uncomplicated. That is why all the video tabs start with a V1. The 1, 2, and ascending numbering after the video version represent the layers in the sequence. Layer 1 is always the bottom layer, and the other layers stack on top. When you rearrange the layers, the tabs will update accordingly. The green tabs are source assignments. So a source has to be loaded in the player, and its video will be assigned via the green tab to the appropriate video track in the active sequence. You can click on the tabs to connect or disconnect them. When two tabs are connected together, Smoke will edit the source clip onto the assigned destination track. Clicking on one tab connects or disconnects it to its corresponding destination track. Shift-clicking on a tab connects or disconnects all the video tabs. Now, coming from another NLE, you might be used to patching your sources by dragging the source tabs up and down to the desired track. However, Smoke's way of patching is a little different. So I'll give you an example of patching video tracks. You can see the source tab is patched to a particular video track. You can also see that the focus point on the positioner is also assigned to the same track. These are actually tied together. When you move the focus point up or down, the source tab will follow after it. You can do this with the page up and page down keyboard shortcuts. It is different from what you are used to, but there are significant benefits. When editing in the sequence, your attention is typically focused where you are working. So by watching the focus point on the positioner, you know exactly where your video will be edited and onto which video track of the sequence. If you prefer a slightly more conventional method of patching the source tabs, click the video track indicator boxes in the patch panel. These boxes normally tell which track you are currently viewing and all the tracks below. But it also acts as a switcher for video patching and moves the focus point too. These two methods of video patching will hopefully get you assigning tracks fast and efficiently. In the next video, we move on to audio patching in the sequence.